to see you.
Hello, Matty.
Hey.
How are you, buddy? Good to see you. How are you? Good to see you. Got the whole first team here, huh?
Morning.
Good morning, sir.
Vice President, George, how are you?
Fine, nice to see you.
Morning, how are you?
Good morning. Good morning. Hello, Jenny.
George.
How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, to see you.
Had a good thing to do.
Sure, I did. Thanks, Bill. I know we're down to deep. Concerns, or maybe some of you made up your mind one way or the other, but I just wanted this chance to talk to you, and also then, if you do have some questions or concerns, I'd like to have a chance for us to address them, to speak about them. The situation of Nicaragua and the proposal that we made, and as you know, of course, it starts in the Senate, so yesterday for hours, we started out for a one-hour meeting yesterday morning, and I had to leave before that was over because of another meeting, and came back and found out later in the day that for 6 hours they've been in there. The Democrats had come up, Bob Byrd had called me and said that they would like to be able to present a consensus kind of approach to where this wouldn't be Democrat versus Republican. This would be closing ranks at the water's edge. So they had come up with a plan somewhat similar to our plan. There were some important differences. There were a number of things that we could buy, and told them so. And the idea was to kind of see if we couldn't meld these two plans. And so they left us with theirs, and they have ours. And they're still going to negotiate, even though today is this morning it's going to be introduced in our plan on the floor. Some of the differences illustrated, I think, some misunderstandings that we all have about the situation in Nicaragua. Ours is one, this whole charge that we're looking for a military overthrow of the Sandinista government, we never have. We know that what we're up against is a revolution that was stolen by one part of the revolutionary group. Just as Castro stole it in Cuba, he executed some of the one-time partners in the revolution. Others were exiled, had to leave the country, and an awful lot of them are over there, what are called the Contras. And our plan, as you know, calls for a period in which both sides will agree to lay down their arms. And the Contras, March 1st, before we ever came up with a plan, proposed that. Announced their willingness to lay down their arms, to go into negotiations and discuss how to restore the original goals of the revolution. And the Sandinistas refused. Teeing off from there, that is our proposal of a period of this. We are working with the Contadora group. They're all in support of this. We're in support of the 21 findings or principles that the Contadoras came up with. I've talked to others, leaders of the neighboring countries and all. The idea that we believe, the only hope is that enough pressure can continue to be put on the Sandinista government that pretty soon they will recognize. We don't believe that we're going to convert them into being nice guys. They're exactly what they look like. They're Marxist, Leninist, dedicated to a totalitarian government, and they're the government. But they're also a basket case economically, and a large part due to the Contras pressure. If we can keep this pressure up, then what we're hoping for is that they'll be faced with a choice, that they can either go along and still participate and be part of the government, or they can take a chance on the rising tide of discontent in that country, in the economic stream of getting kicked out just as Somoza was kicked out. And I'm hopeful that the two plans can kind of meld together in the Senate. But we have no intention of military intervention. Incidentally, one of the big differences between us is the Democratic version in the House calls for us to negotiate with the Sandinistas, not the Contras. Well, we think that's down the road that we went in Vietnam, that's the big colossus of the North again, attempting to go in We don't believe that our allies down there in Costa Rica and Honduras and the other countries would hold still for that. They would think that we were in there, maybe giving away things for our own ends that would be harmful to them in the long run. We believe the negotiations must be between the Contras and the Sandinista government. And all we want is the restoration of the original goals which they gave to the Organization of American States. But now that's enough of an outline for me. What are some of your concerns? Is it anything that we can speak to?
Mr. President,
Increases in defense will be limited to only 3% per year. And I must tell you that this is the rock barrier of Congress to make the necessary reductions in our domestic spending. Economic health of the country will not be easy to get through the political process. It's been said that any government that robs Peter to pay Paul is bound to have the support of Paul. We should do something about that.
Definitely.
Nice to see you.
Me too.
Sir Roy Denman.
Right, come in.
How are you? Nice to see you again, sir.
Mr. Vice President,
how are you, sir? Very nice to see you.
Nice to see you. I understand, but we have Secretary Schultz. You are off to good and solid stuff. Congratulations. I know we're meeting here because we're hopeful that some of you agree to a round of trade talks. Some of you are still lingering in trade relationships.
I hope the Europe is on the track to create a genuine common market and to have an open economy. I think that the entry of Spain of Portugal is an element to reinforce the political field for democracy and peace in Europe.
Good. Okay. We're going to open the door and you'll come in first, okay? And then the rest of you will hold it here until I join you. Yes, as soon as I go in. Okay, then we have Lynn Blaylock.
Right here.
How many family members?
My wife.
Okay, you'll be number two. And then Phil Hanlon?
Yes.
And how many family?
Two.
Okay. What we'll do is I'll open the door and we'll bring you in family at a time in that order, and I'll assist you once we get in here, okay?
Okay.
If we can explain to the folks here, we were holding this as a surprise to you. You are meeting with the President in the Oval Office.
Hello there.
Well, good to meet you.
Well, it's good to meet you. Congratulations.
How do you do?
Hello there. How are you? Well, we have something here I recognize. We have the right one, don't we? No?
Bill? No, I'm not Bill.
No, hey.
I would try.
My fault, sir.
Well, we read that. It would be awful if you got home and found it.
Became Phil.
Well, anyway. Well, all right. And the Vice President?
Yes.
Well, well, we will soon be just going out there to the ceremony with you. Hello there. Nice to see you. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations and thank you for what you're doing. We have a little something here. We think we would like to express our appreciation for what you've done.
Thank you very much. I appreciate having the opportunity to do it.
Well, God bless you.
Sir, right over here. Mr. Phil Hyland, family.
Hi. How are you? Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I'd like to meet my friends.
Hello. Nice to see you. We tried to give this away a few moments ago to the young lady over there, and then realized that her name wasn't. You know, I have a picture taken with this.
Okay. Thank you very much.
And again, congratulations and thank you for all that you're doing, all of you.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you.
We'll all
go over there. Say hello, sir.
We're all going out to the
Okay.
Oh, sure.
Second.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and the Vice President.
Is giving more than money. Last January, Peace Corps Director Lorette Miller Ruby announced a recruitment drive for agricultural volunteers for Africa. Willing to litter up their lives and devote the next 2 years to meeting the emergency. You are a cross-section of America. Now, some of you are first-generation American citizens. You come from all across the country, from Honolulu, Hawaii, to Madawaska, Maine, and you represent a wide range of aid in Africa, where you will be a vital part of the relief aid to help the millions suffering from malnutrition, soil conservation, fisheries production, forest preservation, and water supply development. By bringing your training, a vital journey from dependence on short-term aid to self-sufficiency. Last month, when Vice President Bush returned from his trip to the family,